With just a couple sprites, you can make fun and interactive projects, like animations, stories, greeting cards, and more. To make more complex games and simulations, you're probably going to want a lot of sprites. When you have a group of sprites with the same costume, actions will usually affect all of them. You can make three strawberries like this, and then change the size of all of them with one set size block. If you only want to change the size of one of the sprites, you'll need to use events. This event block is triggered when a sprite is clicked. If we move the set size block over to this event, what will happen when the user clicks a sprite? The event tells the computer to wait for the click and then respond by changing the size of all the strawberries. That's pretty cool, but that's not exactly what we wanted. Events like this one can be expanded with this button. This special block inside lets you control the single sprite that is actually clicked. Let's change out this block. When we run the program this time, we can change the size of each sprite one at a time. You can use this to create simple programs, like a game that tests how fast you can click to remove sprites from the screen. Let's look at another program. Here's a game in progress. The bunnies are gonna wander around and eat the carrots. This block says when touches, and it's an event that involves two different sprites. If you have lots of sprites with these costumes, the special block inside the event block makes sure that things only happen to the sprites that actually touch. Understanding groups of sprites can take some practice, but once you get the hang of it, you'll be able to create amazing games and powerful simulations with just a few blocks of code.